Is that a happy 13-year-old kid or what? Who's going to fly this, Kent or Randy?
Kent's the only one that can.
Idle up.
That's the idle up. It's got two positions. Idle up one and idle up two. And I've got the less throttle.
See if you can take Buddy Weeder's nose off.
But it's kind of scary if you hit the idle up. It's not Buddy Weeder's nose. Can't afford it.
Hey buddy, John Caparo, good to see you. New plane this week.
Oh, thank you.
Really, silky smooth.
Been a while.
Yeah, I missed. I saw you at the NASA, I think. Just for a day.
Yep.
I haven't been out here.
Oh, yeah. Are you flying this year?
No, not quite. I'll just come out later and play around. You know.
Playing around.
Yeah,
with playing around. Fun.
Hey John, I forgot to ask you. You know the dealer I always go by and shoot video of the vets?
Yep.
No vets this year.
Really?
But they got tons of Camaros. What's the deal?
Is he a Chevy dealer?
Yeah, yeah.
Is he going out of business or is he?
No, but he's got Camaros up the ying, but no vets.
Huh.
And last year this time he had three. I used to, on the way to the field every day, I'd take pictures of them.
Wow, they're building them. I mean, they're out
there. I mean, they're not like stop making them or anything.
No.
So you're going to the Ferrari factory first, then the Ducati factory.
Yep.
How cool is that?
Yeah, that'll be fun. It's kind of a dream come true.
Yeah, I'm impressed. We're going in September. We're going on the Danube.
Yeah, the I saw the...
I'll have all the photos to share.
You're going to go from Budapest to...
Very
cool.
3 days in Budapest, yes.
Okay.
And it'll all be on a riverboat.
I heard it's absolutely fantastic.
We've linked up with several people that have taken a tour, and they are going back for the third and fourth time. Karen has all the information. She'll tell you.
Because I got the thing at home.
You're welcome to join us.
Yeah, you were saying you were doing it, so I was like,
join us. Hey, join us. That's all.
Wendy, I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for the help today.
No problem, bud.
Appreciate it.
Buff it out, baby.
I will.
If that isn't a front row plane at the Nats, I'll eat it. I'll eat it. I'll take a bite out of the spinner. And whatever little cosmetic damage you have, just fix it at any price. Don't be a baby.
Okay. I'll man up.
Don't be a second row guy on top 20 day who loses one appearance point. No.
I'm being a man.
No. You want to be right next to the guys in the front row.
That ain't gonna happen. No cats. Good night, everybody.
All right, good night, bud.
Nice see you, man. See you tomorrow.
Oh, for sure.
Good.
I'll be here for you.
Who's really flying it? Is he to fly, Kent?
Yeah, bud.
Give me that stick. I'll show you how to fly it. How many rotor blades you got, Randy?
There's $3 a pair.
Whoa, you better put the car under the tree. Look at this thing go. This is pretty cool. Go out there and scare the hell out of Mason.
No.
Give him a haircut.
Back that baby up.
Now, buddy, I got a buddy.
I can do a twirly bird.
Bernie, when you leave here tonight, do not go through either one of the stop signs. I got caught last night.
I heard it. I heard you crying when you got out.
I was crying.
You're lucky that guy didn't lock you up with that jersey.
And we didn't have the insurance card or registration with us. So as we clean up here and put the helicopters away, the girls have decided it's time to go to Dairy Queen. We didn't have enough junk food today. Don't you know I like cheese? Thrills
night after night. Oh, the fog is out this morning. The fog and the mist, and it's gotten real chilly. It was really chilly last night.
But so far, the big number that counts is we've only had about 5 minutes of rain at the whole contest. And I don't think they've even predicted any for today. But it's just that fog rolling in off the mound. So it's really nice in the morning.
Call me birthday.
It is a foggy morning here in Carmichael's.
Bird almost got whacked. It's a foggy, foggy morning. Today will be the first round of Expert. And then Flying Junkyard Wars, the banquet. And it looks like once the fog burns off, we'll have a wonderful day. Problem is, every day out here is wonderful. Every day is a vacation. They have to wait till some of this fog burns off before they can even put up a flight. Wow. It's the foggiest I've ever seen it here. Pretty eerie. Pretty eerie. Start off the morning with some Canadian humor. They renamed the plane Snack Attack.
I love it. I think that's amazing.
In honor of Ertnowski having snack attacks at Brodak. Oh my God.
Oh my God. All right.
That is good.
I'm having problems here. My shaft is too short. I can't get my spinner on or my thrust washer.
What's the problem?
See this shaft on this Tiger 51? Look how short.
Yeah, they're
it is.
Very short, yeah.
Well, now I can't get my.
You have to relieve the props. You have to have a machine shop thing relieve the prop.
Well, I can relieve the prop, and I have one of those things that goes inside, but it's too long, and then it ends. I gotta get a shorter one because the threads are very short, too. It doesn't go to the back.
So. Maybe that's a hint why they don't make Tiger 51s anymore.
Yeah, might be. Because the holes don't line up with any other motor, I found out too. Perfect, right in the box. Good shot.
Good shot. So that fits on there. But you can't. You don't have enough threads to get the washer on, you said?
No, the washer will go. Where's the washer? Where's the washer? So the washer goes on there. That goes through there, but then see it comes right to the back of the prop.
Oh, you need a thicker washer.
So I need another washer.
Or a thicker one.
Yeah, if I can get a thicker front washer or a second front washer, I'll be in business.
I got thicker washers.
You have one?
Yeah, of course.
That'd be awesome.
Let's see how much thicker it has to be. Eighth of an inch? Eighth?
Yeah, I need another eighth.
Oh, but you know what? Mine are all going to have quarter 28 threads in them, not spinner nut threads. Let me go see what
I
got.
It's just the washer.
Box is right here.
It's just the washer.
Let me see what I got. So we're already starting momentarily. We're about in the middle of the pack, about 2 hours into it. We got the good prop nut for Snack Attack. We just happen to have the right prop nut he needed.
You have a plan for that?
Yes, there's plans, yeah. Look up on the brotherhoodoftherain.org.
Brotherhood of the Ring.
Now, don't look up the Brotherhood of the Ring. Brotherhood of the Ring is a bogus. It's as bogus.
And then now you guys stop fighting. Don't get me in the middle.
It's a Muslim front for collecting money in Texas.
Listen, that nonsense.
Listen, this D. Rice guy, terrorist. Total terrorist. He has Muslim roots. He's
not at all.
That is absolutely a Muslim terrorist.
If they try to give you a ring that makes you turn invisible,
they're
in trouble.
They're bringing people into the country under the auspices of flying model planes. They're smuggling Canadians into Mexico.
It's been nice knowing you. Thanks for coming out.
Anyway, let me tell you the real story. D. Rice starts this Brotherhood of the Ring. So I mentioned to him, I said, I was one of the very few people that's ever won the Nats with a ringmaster. I won in 82, all-time stunt.
Okay.
Due to a judging flaw.
we won't tell anybody.
But anyway, that's not the point. The point is you win. If it's crooked, you win. And what's really neat is he says he's going to induct me into the Brotherhood of the Ring Rings. Hall of Fame. If I build a ringmaster. So I build a ringmaster. He doesn't induct me into the Hall of Fame. He doesn't send me the updates. He doesn't send me video. I got to get all this information from Richard Oliver. So I de-inducted him out of my hall. I de-inducted him.
Jeez, you guys all have halls of fame. This is scary.
That hall of fame's a big thing, boy. It pays the rent.
Well, I haven't got it.
Just for a lark, D wanted a big ringmaster, so Pat Johnson designed this.
Okay.
To make it
this
look
plane
like
flies. I judge this plane. This plane flies really good.
That's awesome. The
pilot's a little on the light side. No, it flew well. Well, you got in the top
look
three
at,
there, didn't
look
you?
At,
no.
Look at.
I got two.
Oh, that's the top three.
Yeah. Wait,
yeah, I got Arkansas. Three. Arkansas. Boy, yeah.
What part of that did he know?
I wanted what? One.
That, oh, okay.
Clinton ran to school where he went. I don't know.
I want the one.
Clinton.
I come in second. Am I in the top three?
No. Didn't make it.
Yeah, you just got nosed out. And then he goes and kicks my ass an old-time stunt off.
With a ringmaster.
It hurts still. I was hurting that and going to bed last night.
Yeah, right.
Karen said, you're not sexy tonight. Joe Gilbert gave you a stomping.
Sanders got both of those back up.
You didn't say that to
Sanders
me.
Sanders is toast. I'm going to psych him out. We got to psych him out next year.
Anyhow, look on that brotherhoodoftheRing.org. And there's a place to go to Pat Johnson's plans. He's got hundreds of sets of plans.
Okay.
Yeah, Pat's a good guy. He does all kind of cool stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome.
It's a beat.
That's good.
It's dwindling, and I'm doing my best to try and...
All right, the frogs, the fogs, the Canadians are rocking and rolling. The planes are out. Time to start the contest. I'm still healing from taking an ass-whipping from John Sanders, and I think there was 10 guys ahead of me. Fly stunt. Patrick Rowan. You gonna go burn him up, Mike?
Yeah, we're gonna try.
Go get him, guy.
We're gonna do what we do.
I know. Morning, Wendy.
Hey, what's going on up in the Detroit area there? You need two pilots to fly this plane, huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
I figured I might as well splurge, right?
You bet. Hey, when you got your kind of money, Obama can't hurt you.
No.
You can't devalue poverty.
No.
He can't print more poverty, but he's trying.
I figure, hell, you know, he's going to just help me out.
That's right. Right.
Give me another, what do they call that? The stimulus?
They're going to stimulate you, all right.
Yep. That'll be good.
Well, I'm looking forward to learning Chinese and working for free.
You know what? And I like Chinese food.
Yeah, I like Chinese food too, so we'll be eating it pretty soon.
Yeah.
Oh, that poor sun is just dying to come out. Please, I'll burn that fog off in 10 minutes. Please.
Hey, Wendy, check this out.
I saw him. Yeah, he said me flies good.
My first round of profile, I didn't do this.
What helps him out is having that reverse turn and prop, Joe. Now, guess what? Guess who has a reverse mold? For a 14 three blade. No, I got it.
That's what I mean.
All we got to do is get Richard to make reverse turn and crankshaft. That's no big deal.
There you go.
I already got them for the 40. I just got to get one for a 76. That's a cool idea. I suggested that to Palco, I think last year or 2 years ago, because I have reverse turn and carbon props. But I think they're too big for the electrics.
There are guys down in Texas making reverse cranks.
Hmm?
There are guys.
No.
There's lines out there.
It's no big deal to do it. When Dub makes an engine, they just take a crank out and 45 degrees to the other side. Man, did you enjoy your visit to my house that day?
Oh, it was fantastic.
Oh, man, it's like going to go to Mecca, huh?
Oh, man, I'll tell you. I thought I was in a tie.
It's like going to a terrorist headquarters and getting recruited. They're recruiting them for the Spitfire program.
There you go.
So I heard you're building. You're building crazy, huh?
Yeah, man.
Joe's helping you out?
Yes, sir.
Beautiful.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Joe's a good man.
A lot of Musco designs, man.
Absolutely.
They're beautiful. Hey, work.
Work for me.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I've had six or eight of them.
made all the difference in the
I lost.
Oh, you took the rubber bands off for a piece.
Yes, you bet I did. Right. I lost my two front magnets when I in the crash. I couldn't find them, so I got.
Forward and aft.
It's
so you can adjust the CG.
I can move the battery, you know.
Front to back.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I could lower it and raise it if I wanted to. I found that was pretty good.
Okay.
And the fuselage is totally open, so you can get to your control system.
Me and Wendy are waiting for you guys to perfect it. Then when you perfect it.
Oh, okay. Fuselage is open. All right.
But the reverse turn and prop is a plus.
What's the weight of the battery?
16 ounces.
16 ounces. How about the motor itself?
I think it's about 9.
Get Richard Oliver psyched up to make some crankshafts this year.
Oh, yeah, it doesn't weigh much.
Of course, if you don't have the mold for the props, the crankshafts aren't worth much.
I mean, when you look at a gas.
One port weighs about an ounce.
He's got the whole disease. He's got the shirt, the matching pants. All he needs is yellow sneakers now. Now here's what he needs is the yellow hat to match the Iron Horse. Get him a Ferrari hat.
So if you wanted a little bit more, you could dial in a little more right at the line.
Depending upon the conditions.
Right.
Everything.
What do you generally do? Just run it wide open or?
No, I'm running it about
90% or
85%.
Okay.
And that way that you don't want to run it at 100 because then your governor doesn't have any more to give. So you want to run it at least, you know, 80, 85%, and when it pulls vertical, it's got some more to put into
sense.
It when it needs it.
It's the same as, basically, the same as VFD in electrical motors. Okay, when you need more, it allows it. You don't want to run them at 100%.
Right.
You want to have that modulation point where you can increase or decrease depending upon demand.
See, he's already got it, more of it down than I do.
Well, Lou's in a kind of business where he has to know about electrical loads and things like that.
I do a lot of HVAC.
Okay.
And VFDs, variable frequency drive motors, is the big thing for saving energy today. And it kind of runs under the same principle as that motor.
Yeah, and almost
okay.
any... Almost
and it's
every...
AC, which is the easiest to control.
Okay. The speed controls now that you buy almost
I'm
all
sorry,
of them...
DC.
Yeah, DC.
That's right.
They have a governor built into the speed controls and... You either get a programming card, or you can get a little link to your computer and set them up that way.
And that's the other wonderful. You can have a program. You can set up with a computer. So fantastic. Now you have a timer, which gives you the time. Then
right.
Okay.
And I'm going to bump it up a little bit because I.
When you charge your battery.
Yes.
Okay. How do you charge your battery, at home or in your car?
No, at home I have a 12-volt power supply because it's a DC charger. And here I just bring a deep cycle battery and charge them at the field.
Here you bring a what?
A deep cycle car battery.
Oh, okay.
Green battery.
You have a loose battery with you.
Yes.
And it takes what, 45 minutes to charge?
About 45 minutes.
Okay, does it lose memory? Doesn't lose memory, or you have to be careful?
I think over the lifespan that I'm figuring I'm gonna get a season out of these batteries. And they'll still be good for something else.
Okay.
But they kind of start losing their effectiveness.
Okay. And you said the battery is what, $50 a piece?
These are. You can spend from $50 to $250 if you want to.
I want the $250.
The $250 batteries are.
Shit.
This one's 16 ounces. You'll probably get it for $12.
I wouldn't want it to
you
get
can
dead
save
on.
I want them chrome too.
And they're probably a better grade cell,
it's
and they might last a year and a half. But even the good ones are going to die. So.
Okay.
That's Earl Armstrong, right?
I remember Whiteley flying his original.
Yeah, yeah, in Virginia. Yep. Look at this. There's always somebody looking to steal a show by building a twin. Always somebody looking to steal a show. That's why you need tattoos, to fly a twin.
Thank you.
That's a nice setup you got, Jim, for flipping it over like that. Pretty cool.
Thanks.
Can you grab this back over?
Yeah. Can you grab that thing out from under it?
Yeah.
How much do you weigh? Did you weigh it on a scale there?
Yeah, 74 ounces.
74?
Yeah, it's lighter than a Strega.
Not my Strega.
You remember you sold me that bell crank and stuff that's all
it's in
there?
Be careful when you pull test it. Don't stand on the edge of a cliff. Man.
They're only guaranteed to 68 ounces.
Don't stand on the end of a cliff when you pull test it.
Says right on it, one engine only.
Huh. I sold you one of single engine ones.
Sold me a factory second, did you?
They're all factory second. Oh. I keep the good ones. Oh, man.
I like it. I think we're good to go. I hope so.
I can't wait to see it fly. How come you weren't flying this before up the hill and stuff?
I haven't had any luck with it.
What's the issue that it...
Yeah, one engine always... Well, one thing is it's big. It's hard to get it around.
What kind of motors are in there?
Rodak 40s.
Okay, so... What's not to like? I mean, 74 with two motors, divide that in half, it's a 24-ounce plane or something.
Exactly. Mm. We
you like my math?
Or an 80 engine.
Don't you go, I don't work for Obama.
Right, here.
We have $1 million. I keep $1 million, you get nothing.
Yeah, there you go.
Seems fair, right?
Obamanomics.
Yeah.
Was it the outboard engine giving you trouble?
Yeah. Not the engine.
If you're going to have a bad one, it's got to be the outer one. You don't want the inner one to be the bad one.
No,
trust me on that.
To.
I got a lot of twin time.
Yeah, you know what? It's scary, isn't it? The first one you did.
The scariest thing in the world is the honest stooge by myself. One day, the inner engine shut off as the stooge released. The inner engine.
Uh-oh.
It came across the circle. I jumped up in the air, caught it on the other end. Didn't break anything. Just busted the lead out guide. It taxied so nice with one engine, but it's the outer engine and the tip weight combined to make a slot car out of it.
Are you sure about 3 3/4?